Hey, Meebee family, my name is Nikki. I'm the clinical director of speech language pathology, and today I'm going to walk you through how to help your child to say eat. Now, we are going to first start with having a communication temptation. What that means is I'm going to create an opportunity for my child to be able to communicate for me. Right now, I have my graham crackers in a box. These are graham crackers from Trader Joe's. However, you can see that I've opened this box. This is not a communication opportunity because it's very easy to get inside. Instead, what I've done is I put them inside a clear plastic bag. This is a great way to be able to help your child to not have access to the items, but to be able to see them very clearly. Now, some of our kiddos are really good at opening plastic bags. If they are, I'm not going to hand this to them, but I will have access to it. But before I do any of that, I'm gonna really think about, I already know my child's probably motivated by food, and I'm gonna think about what food items they're really motivated by, and I'm gonna start there. And once I do that, I'm going to also think about, do they understand how to request to eat? Are they pointing? Are they looking at the food? Are they grabbing my hand? Are they pulling me to the food items? If they're not doing any of those, I might show them how to do that. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to show them what food is. So every time I have food and I give them a snack, I'm gonna go, eat. Eat crackers. And I'm going to show them that probably 10 to 20 times over multiple days, multiple experiences with food. And so what I'm doing first is I'm prepping them. This is what I expect. This is what I'm showing you how you can communicate here. So I'm going to first teach them the understanding around the routine, which if you watch any of my other videos, it's really important that they understand what they're supposed to communicate and what the expectations are and why. Otherwise, they're going to learn a word and they're never going to use it. We're gonna wonder why they have so many words, but they're not using any of them. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to pretend like my child does not know the word, and I'm gonna show you what I will do. I will do, eat. I will show them first. I will open up my graham crackers and I will pull out a graham cracker and give them one. There is no waiting time. I'm not having them do anything at first. I'm just showing them, I'm modeling is what we call it, and then I'm going to hand my kiddo the snack, the graham cracker. Now, some of these are pretty big, so it's pretty easy to give a pretty big graham cracker. With goldfish, I don't really recommend giving one at a time because how frustrating is that to get one piece at a time? I usually have a little bowl and I pour a little bit in. So for right now, I'm going to pretend like my child already had one, and I've practiced this now about 20 times. So I've showed my child through multiple different types of snacks, different food items, and I've been modeling the sign for eat. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to show them how they can do it, and it's going to be very, very quick. The key here is quick. We're not waiting a long time. If you wait, your child's gonna get frustrated, and then it's not fun to communicate with you. So why would I communicate? It's easier if I just point or I grab. If I grab, I get the item faster. Why would I not grab? So we wanna teach our child how to be able to do this in a successful way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show them the food. I know that they want graham crackers, and I'm going to say, eat. I'm going to take their hand, I'm gonna put it to their mouth, and I'm gonna say, eat. And then I'm gonna open it up, I'm going to hand them a cracker. The reason I'm going to take their hand super quickly is because I just want them to understand what they can do. They're not required, I'm not waiting, they're not required to say it on their own. If they do, fantastic. My job's already halfway done. But most of the time, they're not. Most of the time, we are teaching them how to be able to request, and it takes a lot of time. So what it looks like is taking their hand and putting it to their mouth. Often it's like this, often it's like this. It's okay. It does not have to be bunched for the actual sign for eat. We're just looking for them to be able to understand that something towards their mouth means eat, and what that means is that I communicate and I get my snack. So once my child really understands this concept, I might pull out my crackers again. Now take in mind that I've been practicing. My child's arm is starting to go a little bit easier when I'm helping them. And this isn't a forceful grab. This is a quick, gentle, guidance to be able to show them what they can do to communicate. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to show them the food and I'm gonna say, eat, and then I'm gonna wait. Not wait a long time. Remember, we're not waiting a long time. The goal is not frustration, the goal is success. So I'm waiting and I show them, eat, and hear how my voice is saying, okay, that's what you're supposed to say. So I'm not sitting and I'm saying, eat, I'm saying, eat. My whole body is telling you that this is your turn, eat. And then I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna wait 5 seconds, which feels like, it doesn't sound like very long. It'll feel like an eternity. Most of Most of us are not waiting that long because we want to fill the silence. But this is important. You've already taught your child what the expectations are and what they could do to request, and now we want to wait just a little bit longer and give them an opportunity. Now, if we wait 5 seconds, and in our head we're counting, we're not counting out loud. If we wait 5 seconds and they have not requested, that's okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show them eat, and then I'm going to open it up and I'm going to hand them their cracker. This is not something where they have to say it multiple times. We are not trying to get them to repeat, 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 or try to do it. Or I'm waiting and I'm showing them eat, eat, eat. As soon as I start doing this multiple times, I have lost my child. Once we've lost them, it's really hard to get them back re-engaged and motivated and excited because they don't feel successful. And who wants to participate if you don't feel successful? So I hope this was a fun tip. It's a really great way to be able to help your child across multiple different ways. You can start with just even cracker. Right, so the sign for cracker. So this is a great way to be able to help your child to communicate. And by using sign language, you're actually helping your child to be able to later use a verbal word. It sounds a little bit tricky, right? Using a sign, if I use the sign, that's the only way they're gonna communicate. But what we find and what research shows us is giving a child a way to access and communicate leads them to further imitation. So the more you use sign language and the more you make it easy for your child to communicate, the more they're likely to try verbal communication as well. Thanks for tuning in, Meavy family. Stay tuned for more tips and tricks.
Yahoo! Yippee! Yippee! Meavy!